The nation's vaccine experts have revised their vaccine advice yet again. Authorities now say that people in outbreak areas under the age of 60 should rethink the AstraZeneca jab, saying the benefits outweigh the risks.
A shot in church. Reverend Bill Cruz rolling out Pfizer vaccinations for Sydney's rough sleepers and homeless. For many of these people, staying home isn't an option.
They don't go very well with rules and all of that sort of stuff. But in order to keep society safe, we have to look after them as well.
In the wake of the Sydney outbreak, the nation's vaccine experts, ATAGI, have some fresh advice. Pfizer remains the preferred vaccine for those under 60, but in hotspot suburbs, if there's no access to Pfizer right now, it says the risk-benefit balance tips in favour of having the AstraZeneca shot. ATAGI recommends adults under 60 years who do not have immediate access to Pfizer should reassess the need for vaccination with AstraZeneca, given these greater benefits. In some areas, the recommended 12 weeks between AZ shots has also been brought forward, now between 4 to 8 weeks, and GPs agree.
If you're in an area where there's a lot of COVID, it would make sense to bring forward your immunisation. So I would say if you live in the Greater Sydney area, then it's very reasonable to bring your second jab forward to 6 or 8 weeks.
Unfortunately, the message is lockdown is the only way we've got to stop this and get it back to zero community transmission, which is the only safe thing until we get to 90% or so of the whole population vaccinated, and that's a long way off.
Around 9% or 2.25 million Australians have been fully vaccinated since the program began in late February. But that leaves around 15 million Aussies over the age of 18 still waiting. And that's largely due to a shortage of the offshore manufactured Pfizer vaccine.
South Australia is taking a plan to the federal government to manufacture Pfizer and Moderna doses in Adelaide. It won't help in the short term. If approved, the plant would need 9 months minimum to fire up. Lizzie Pearl, Nine News.